I was just thinking when I was preparing this. So I was sitting with my wife, and we were talking about back and forth and back and forth, all of these things that happened. And you know, the ayah, like what the ayah that you mentioned, and even the ayah, Ya Bani Israil, اذكروا نعمتي التي أنعمت عليكم وأني فضلتكم على العالمين. If you look at the Muslim situation, if you look at all of the fadl, like afdal, all of the good things that Allah Azza wa Jal has given this ummah, right? Look, how many favors of Allah will you deny Bani Israel? When you want shade, Allah gives you shade. When you want water in your land, Allah doesn't give you 1, 2, 3, Allah gives you 12 springs, just water coming. When you want food, Allah doesn't give you just food from just go and grow and show you. Allah could have done that. Allah brings you the best of it. If you look at us, the Muslim Ummah, and look at our lands, what don't we have? The best of the resources, oil, power, population, the amount of numbers of the Muslim Ummah, the strategic lands that we have, the resources that have been given to us, the kind of people Allah has given us, the kind of resources, all of that Allah Azza wa Jalla has given us, but we turn our backs to Allah. And that became the reason for punishment, that you keep denying the favors of Allah Azza wa Jalla. And the favor of Allah Azza wa Jalla, that Allah gave you haqq. So you have to stand with haqq. And He gave you miracles after miracles to prove you that haqq. So you don't have any kind of doubt in your mind that is this from Allah or not. And even then you deny it all. And this is the point that you're making, is that you look at, we are willing to do the evil. Look, lesser of two evils, it's evil on both ends. But we want to do the evil. I mean, if you know, look at, you put all of those things aside, tell me, the brothers here who have children, just be honest with me, will you teach your children and say, take the lesser of two evils? When you have the haqq, it's not that, okay, I have to make a choice between this and tea, maybe it's not too good for you, yani maybe tea is, in this, not what I'm talking about, I'm saying, the haqq is right in front of you, here, this is the haqq, oh my son, but choose the lesser of two evils. This is what we're teaching them, is that haqq, no, if you're going to take haqq, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, oh, there's going to be struggle. Ya Shaykh, the issue is, the moment you stand to enjoin the good and forbid the evil, there's going to be struggle. There's a struggle, there is now threats, now there is issues, now you have to deal with the community, now you have to deal with people who don't like what you have to say. The moment you start speaking the haqq, that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَالْعَصْرِ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرِ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِنُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَتَوَاسُوا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاسُوا بِالصَّبْرِ. Allah Azza wa Jal is saying all of this, that look, the moment you stand up for haqq, you're going to have patience, because there will be people who will not like you. You will not like you. And that's the issue. We don't want to enjoin the good and forbid the evil. And you know what? And this is our lot. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent us for no other reason than this. No other reason than this. This ummah, the only reason for this ummah, brothers and sisters, wallahi, look. And you know, one more thing. The moment Bani Israel decided that they will not enjoin the good and forbid the evil, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replaced them by a whole different nation called the Muslim ummah. A whole Muslim nation, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they came and they enjoined the good and they forbid the evil and they warned them of what they have done and to stop the nonsense that they were doing, and Allah Azza wa Jal gave them victory. And today, this ummah, us, if we're not going to stop the behavior of following Bani Israel and not going back to Quran and the Sunnah and the Sahaba, there will be another generation of people, another nation who will come, who will love Allah, and Allah will love them. And they will fulfill the promise of Allah. There will be another Yusha bin Nun. There is no question about it. It's going to happen because this is Wa'ad Allah. What is our role in it? If you have anything, go ahead, continue. You can, if you have anything else to add, anyone else, you know, if you have anything else to add, please add. Look, Allah Azza wa Jalla said, تَعْوَانُ عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَتَقْوَى وَلَا تَعْوَانُ عَلَى الْإِسْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ. You know, Allah Azza wa Jalla is telling us, Allah didn't say to us the lesser of two evil. Actually, Allah said, when they call you to do good and khair, الْبِرِّ وَالْ, you know, وَالْتَقْوَى. When they call you to taqwa and fearing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you join hands and do that. But when they call you to the enmity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to do sin, then you reject it. Allah didn't say choose between those two evils. Any, go ahead.